I am Padmini Narkar, teacher from Chembur Naka MPS School. Today's subject is English. And let's have a revision on Unit 4, Topic 4.4, My Financial Career. Open your English textbooks, Kumar Bharati, Standard 9, Unit 4.4, page number 100. Now, the picture that you see on the screen right now is Stephen P.H. Butler-Leacock. He is the writer of this story, My Financial Career. So let's go through him, his details quickly. He was a Canadian teacher, political scientist, writer, and humorist between the years 1915 and 1925. He was the best known English speaking humorist in the world. He is known for his light humor along with criticism of people's follies. My financial career, let's start with the warming up. When you open a savings account at bank, you need to fill up deposit form slips, observe the following forms and fill up your details. Now see here, on page number 100, what you see right now is a paying slip. Many of you must have visited banks to deposit cash or check. So how do you fill the slip? Now the slip in front of you that you see on the screen, I'll just help you out how to fill in the details if it's the first time for somebody. Now see, your financial career, it's also a bit of financial knowledge for you too. You should know how to deal with the financial transactions in the bank. So the first thing that you need to fill in the slip is the date. This date is the date you're going to deposit that check or cash, okay? Then the branch, that is which branch you're going to fill in the cash or check. Then for the creditor, like in whose name you're going to, like in whose account you're going to deposit that amount, okay? Then the account number, you need to mention the account number. The next is you need to fill in the cash denominations, the amount, the notes that you're going to deposit. If it's a check, you need to write the check is drawn on which bank. Like here it is mentioned, State Bank of India. Then next is that check is of which branch. Here it is mentioned Ghatkopar. It depends on which branch that check has been drawn from. Then the check number, okay? Check number is the first digits below when you see the check, the number that has been mentioned. Then the amount, you need to write in words and figures, okay? And then after that, you need to write in the address, okay? Your telephone number, your mobile number, your email address, okay? So these are the things that you need to fill in the paying slip, either the for cash or for the check, okay? So let's proceed. Now, question number two, write in your own words. Why does the bank need so many details of its customer? Now, we need to fill in so many details regarding the customer. So what do you think? Why the bank needs all these things? Okay. Now, the bank needs so many details of its customer to avoid fraudulent transactions and safeguard their accounts. Banks ask questions to its customers on different matters because they want to know them and their life situation so that they can provide good advice and offer banking services suited to the needs of its customers through Know Your Customers, that is KYC. Banks get information from customers so that they can support banks against crime and bear their share of social responsibility. You know, they need to make the customers alert about the fraud that is going on. They need to make the customers aware. So that's the reason they try to take all the information through the KYC, that is Know Your Customer. Okay. Now next one. The second question is, what problems do customers face when they have to make a cash deposit at a bank? Now, if you have visited a bank, you also must have come across such a problem. Some of the problems that customers have to face when they have to make a cash deposit at a bank are that there is a long queue. You know, there's a queue, there's a lot of rush in the bank. and everyone is busy, so everyone wants their work to be done very fast. The long queue, so it consumes a lot of time. Knowledge of filling up the details of a form is a must, which is troublesome for illiterate people. Now, because you are educated, you know, you will be able to fill in the details. But what about the people who are illiterate, who do not know to read and write? Sometimes the bank server is down and not functioning, which can be a problem in depositing cash. Moreover, many banks will need not let you deposit cash into an account which does not bear your name as an account holder. So if you do not have an account in that bank, you will not be able to deposit the cash. So these are the problems that a customer may face. Next one is, what are the latest modern methods of depositing money in your own or somebody else's account? Now, if you don't have an account in the bank, or you know, if you go to deposit money and you don't want to waste your time over there, so what are the methods now, different methods that has that have started right now? Now, some of the latest modern methods of depositing money in our own or somebody else's account are the ATM counters. You know, you can deposit money through the ATM counters. You can withdraw cash at any automated teller machine, check at pay orders, electronic fund transfers, and standing order. You can also give standing instructions to the bank. Okay, let's move on. Even there is SWIFT, international account transfer. Like if you want to send money out of India, you can use SWIFT. Online banking, you have the OD facility, that is overdraft facility, and banking through apps. Nowadays, the banks have started, you know, you can download the app in your mobile and you can do your banking transactions through that also. Now, question number three, make a verb, a word web of at least 12 words related to banking. Now, see, mostly you see in your question, in your writing, when you're writing 80 marks paper, your English paper, this question you come across for 2 marks. Okay, you have to write words related to that specific word. Now, the word mentioned over here is banking. So what things come in front of your mind when you hear the word banking? Now, some of the words related to banking are as follows. Balance. Okay, you need to check the balance in your account. Bank statement. You require the monthly bank statements or you to see the transactions, whatever has taken place. You need to check in with the bank statement. Borrower, you know, you may be a borrower from the bank, like if you're taking a loan or something. Then card holder, okay, you have a debit card, credit card. Then credit limit. Then there's a depositor. Interest, that is main thing. When you're depositing some amount, you have to, you know, you get some interest from the bank. Then overdraft facility, passbook, savings, telebanking, pain slip, which we just saw some time back, withdrawal, etc. So these are the words that are related to banking. Okay. Now let's move on to the chapter. We are finished with the warming up session. I hope I'm audible to everyone and everyone can see my screen quite clearly. If you can't see the screen, you can open your textbooks, page number 101, My Financial Career by Stephen Leacock. Now I'll give a quick reading to this chapter. And I will explain you the questions related to this chapter. When I go into a bank, I get rattled. The clerks rattle me. The wickets rattle me. The sight of the money rattles me. Everything rattles me. Now, here the author, Stephen Leacock, he wants to say that, you know, whenever he enters the bank, he gets rattled. Means he's very nervous. Everything in his body, he's shaking, like he's trembling. Okay. Now, why? Because he has never visited a bank. Now, the people who already always visit a bank, they are very confident. They know what transactions they have to do and how to deal with the people over there and which counter to go for doing their work and everything. But when the person is going for the first time, even you must have experienced this thing, you are a little nervous because you don't know what you like where to go, whom to talk to and all these things. Okay. The moment I cross the threshold of a bank, I am a hesitating J. If I attempt to transact business there, I become an irresponsible idiot. Now, this the author is talking about his own self, that he's, you know, whenever he enters the bank, the doorstep of the bank, he's a person who does not know anything. He thinks like he's a fool in the bank over there because he's unaware about what he has to do in the bank. Okay. I knew this beforehand. But my salary had been raised to $50 a month And I felt that the bank was the only place for it. Now, he was lucky enough, his salary had raised, and he thought like now the savings should start. So he thought of the bank where he could save his money. So that was the time that he had to visit the bank to save his money, that whatever he wanted to save. So I shambled in and looked timidly around at the clerks. I had an idea that a person about to open an account must need consult the manager. Now, what he thought is, if he has to open an account in an in any bank, he has to meet the manager. So he went inside the bank and he was looking where the manager was. I went up to a wicket marked accountant. The accountant was a tall, cool devil. The very sight of him rattled me. My voice was sepulchral. Okay, now, when he entered the bank, he was searching for a manager because he wanted to open an account. So he went to a place, you know, when you see there are different windows in a bank and the designation of the person is written. So here he went to a place where it was marked accountant. So that accountant, he was a tall man. And for this person, because he's going for a first time, he was like, he thought him, you know, he is described him as a tall, cool devil. Okay. And when he stood in front of him, his voice went low. Okay. Because he was nervous. "Can I see the manager?" I said, and added solemnly, "Alone?" I don't know why I said alone. Now, what he asked the accountant was, he wanted to speak to a manager, and that also he mentioned alone. He didn't know how that word alone came out of his mind. Okay. "Certainly," said the accountant, and fetched him. The manager was a grave, calm man. I held my $56 clutched in a crumpled ball in my pocket. "Are you the manager?" I said. God knows I didn't doubt it. "Yes," he said. "Can I see you?" I asked. "Alone?" I didn't want to say alone again, but without it, the thing seemed self-evident. Now, just because in front of the accountant, he had told that he wanted to meet the manager alone. So when the manager came in front of him, again, he asked him alone. So he had to mention it, yes, alone. The manager looked at me in some alarm. He felt that I had an awful secret to reveal. Now, you know, nowadays no one wants to meet a manager without they have any some personal some secret work, because to open an account, no one will go and you know, ask for a manager. They will go and they will fill in the formalities, whatever the details are there, and they will open a new account. But now, because since this person insisted on meeting a manager, the manager thought that there was something secret. So "Come in here," he said, and led the way to a private room. He turned the key. Now, because this person wanted to see the manager alone, he took him to a cabin to you know, talk to this person. "We are safe from interruption here," he said. "Sit down." We both sat down and looked at one another. I found no voice to speak. "You are one of Pinkerton's men, I presume," he said. Now, what the manager thought, like, he's from, like, this author, Stephen Leacock, is from some secret spy agency. Pinkerton, maybe that's the agency that is there in that country. So the manager just tried to guess, like, who this person was. Children, please turn to page number 102. He had gathered from my mysterious manner that I was a detective. I knew what he was thinking, and it made me worse. Now, the manager, he took him to a room over there to so that this person could speak to him personally. And the manager thought that this person who wanted to meet him was a detective. "No, not from Pinkerton's," I said, seemingly to imply that I came from a rival agency. "To tell the truth," I went on, "and if I had I had been prompted to lie about it, I'm not a detective at all. I have come to open an account. I intend to keep all my money in this bank." Now, the manager, like, this person thought that manager is thinking that he's a detective from Pinkerton, but then he told him that he's not from Pinkerton. So maybe then the manager thought that maybe not Pinkerton, but then some other rival agency, like some other detective agency. But then he made it clear that he is not a detective at all, and he has come here to open an account, and he wants to keep all his money in his bank. Now the manager thought that maybe he's some big shot, you know, millionaire, you know, billionaire, where he wants to keep his money and a lot of money in the bank. So maybe he needs some VIP treatment. The manager looked relieved, but still serious. He concluded now that I was the son of a baron, Rothschild, or a young Bald. Now, this person is a billionaire in US. So like how we have Ambani is here. So the manager thought that maybe this person who has visited the bank is very rich. And, you know, he has a lot of money, which he wants to deposit in the bank. A large account, I suppose, he said. Now the manager is thinking like he's having a lot of money and he wants to deposit it in the bank. Fairly large, I whispered. I propose to deposit $56 now and $56 a month regularly. Now see what he's saying, that the manager thought that he was a very rich person and he has to open an account with a lot of money to deposit. But what this person said, yes, $56. Mm-hmm. Now, if you check in $56, an approximate amount of rupees, 4,000. Okay. So he had to open a new account with a starting amount of 4,000. That is $56. Okay. But for this person, this amount was quite a big amount because his salary had raised and the extra amount that he was having, he wanted to save in the bank. But for the manager, this amount was, you know, a small amount because he thought that he was a billionaire and he's going to open account with a lot of money. But looking, you know, when he heard about $56, the manager was really angry. The manager got up and opened the door. He called to the accountant. Like when he came to know that this person who was talking to me in personal, he wants to sit in a room and discuss with me. He has come to open a new account. And what is the amount that he wants to deposit? Just $56. So this work could be done even at the accountant level. You don't need a manager for this, right? So the manager, he said, he called the accountant. Mr. Montgomery, he said, unkindly loud, this gentleman is opening an account. He will deposit $56. Good morning. So, you know, he said it sarcastically to the accountant. Like, he has come here, he's meeting me personally. And what work does he have? Just to open an account. And what is the amount? $56. I rose. A big iron door stood open at the side of the room. Good morning, I said, and stepped into the safe. Come out, said the manager coldly, and showed me the other way. Our manager told him, you go and meet some other person, that is the accountant. I went up to the accountant's wicket and poked the ball of money at him with a quick convulsive movement, as if I were doing a conjuring trick. So the amount that he was carrying was in his pocket. So he went to the window where the accountant was sitting and he gave him the money. My face was ghastly pale. Because, you know, the way the manager behaved with this person, he was little unwell. Here, I said, deposit it. The tone of the words seemed to mean, let us do this painful thing while the fit is on us. He took the money and gave it to another clerk. He made me write the sum on a slip and sign my name in a book. I no longer knew what I was doing. The bank swam before my eyes. Now, the accountant asked him to fill a slip, like how we did it at the beginning in the warming up session, the amount that he had to deposit and all these things. He took the money and gave it to another clerk. Okay. And he wrote that accountant made him write all these things. Is it deposited? I asked in a hollow, vibrating voice. It is, said the accountant. Now, when he filled the slip, the accountant deposited his money in that account. Then I want to draw a check. Now, just imagine he had just opened a new account. He deposited his $56 right now. And now what this person is saying, that he wants to withdraw that amount. Like he wants a check from which he can withdraw that amount. Children, turn your page to page number 103. My idea was to draw out $6 of it for present use. Now, he had deposited $56, okay? And now he wants to withdraw $6. So he asked the accountant, like he wants a checkbook. Someone gave me a checkbook through a wicket and someone else began telling me how to write it on. Now, they came to know, the people in the bank, the people who are working in the bank, they came to know that this person is unaware about how to, you know, fill in the details or how the work goes on in the bank. So they told him, like, if you want to withdraw the amount, you need to write in the checkbook the amount, you know, the check slip, and you need to write in the amount that you need to withdraw. So someone gave him a checkbook through a wicket and someone else began telling him how to write it out. The people in the bank had the impression that I was an invalid millionaire. I wrote something on the check and thrust it in it at the clerk. He looked at me. Now what happened? That one person from the bank, he gave him the checkbook. showed him how to, you know, fill in the details. Now this person, he wrote something on that, like some amount on the bank, and he gave it back to the clerk. And the clerk started staring at him. What are you drawing it out? It all out again? He asked in surprise. Now what happened? Actually, the author, he wanted to withdraw $6, and the amount that he had deposited was $56. But what happened? Because he was nervous, instead of writing six on that check, he wrote 56. That means the amount which he deposited just now, some time back, he's withdrawing all that amount. Okay. So in surprise, that person was asking. Then I realized that I had written 56 instead of six. Okay. By that time, that author was not knowing that by mistake he had written 56. I was too far gone to reason now. I had a feeling that it was impossible to explain the thing. All the clerks had stopped writing to look at me. Now, everyone working in the bank was surprised that this person has gone mad. He just came here, he opened a new account, he deposited $56. Now he's asking for a checkbook and he wants to withdraw the amount, and again 56. So what was the use of coming in the bank then? But they didn't know that this person is doing this transaction for the first time. He doesn't know how the bank transactions work. No, he's doing it for, and he's nervous. And by mistake, he had written six. But now, even this person is not agreeing that, you know, it is by mistake. He didn't want to show that he is nervous, and he didn't want to show that he is, you know, unaware about how the bank transactions work. Reckless with misery, I made a plunge. Yes, the whole thing. Now, here again, he made a mistake. He's saying, yes, I want to withdraw the whole amount. He didn't agree that he has made a mistake. You withdraw your money from the bank, every cent of it. Are you not going to deposit anymore? Said the clerk, astonished. Now the clerk, again, is trying to confirm that, sir, you just deposited $56 and now you are withdrawing it. Are you sure? He's asking you. Never. An idiot hope struck me that they might think something had insulted me while I was writing the check and that I had changed my mind. I made a wretched attempt to look like a man with a fearfully quick temper. Now, he started acting like he has been insulted and now he's angry with the bank people. And so he doesn't want to deposit any money with the bank. He's angry with the bank colleagues inside, the bank people over there. And he's a very he's a man with a bad temper. And so because he got angry and he wants to withdraw all the amount, the clerk prepared to pay the money. How will you have it? He said. Now, because he has asked for $56, so that clerk is asking, like, how you want in what denomination? Like, how we have a 2,000 rupee note, we have a 500 rupee note. So in what denominations you want? What? How will you have it? Oh, I caught the meaning and answered without even trying to think, in 50s. Now, his amount was $56. And how he wants the amount is, he's saying in 50s. So now 50s means what? 50 and 6, right? So that means he will get a note of 50 and he will... change in $6. Okay. He gave me a $50 bill and the six, he asked dryly. In sixes, I said. He gave it me and I rushed out. Like, now this man came to know what a fool he was. He went to the bank. He deposited, he opened a new account. He deposited the money and then he asked for a check to withdraw the money, and instead of withdrawing $6, he has withdrawn the full amount. And in that also, when they asked him how he wants the amount, he's saying in 50s. So it was just $56. So he got one note of 50 and the balance amount the $6. Okay, so he knew that everyone has come to know that this person doesn't know how the transactions are done. So he just took the money and he rushed out of the bank. As the big door swung behind me, I caught the echo of a roar of laughter that went up to the ceiling of the bank. Now, as soon as he came out of the bank, everyone in the bank, all the people who were working in the bank and whoever were watching what this person is doing, they all started laughing so loudly that it could be heard outside. Okay. Since then, I bank no more. Like from this time, this author, he is having a strange feeling about the bank and all this experience that he had. He decided to bank no more. I keep my money in cash in my trousers pocket and my savings in silver dollars in a sack. So he what he decided is, of course, it is wrong. He should have not decided as such that he will never go to the bank and he will never deposit any of his savings in the bank. Okay. So we have finished with the chapter right now. Let's move on. I hope you all have enjoyed it. Now, let's see to the in-text questions. The first question that is, what makes the narrator nervous at a bank? Okay. The clerks, the wicket, the sight of the money rattles the writer. Rattles means makes him nervous. In short, everything in a bank makes the narrator nervous. What word should he have avoided in his request to see the manager? In his request to see the manager, as I read the chapter, you came to know that by mistake he had used the word alone. So if the writer had, he should have not used the word alone. So the writer should have avoided the word alone. Why was the manager alarmed? Like, why was he surprised? The manager was alarmed because the writer told him that he wanted to meet him alone. He thought that the writer had an awful secret to reveal. Who did he think was his visitor? Now, what did the manager think? Why did the author want to meet him alone? The manager thought that his visitor was one of Pinkerton's men, like maybe a person from a detective agency. What procedure did the author have to follow to open the account? To open the account, the writer had to meet the accountant, write the sum on a slip, and sign his name in a book. So that was just the procedure that he had to follow. What error did the author make in the check? Did he correct it? Now, as we all know, as we have gone through the chapter, the author, he wanted to withdraw only $6. But by mistake, he wrote 56. So instead of writing the amount as only $6, the writer made a very silly error of writing it as $56. And did he correct it? No. Okay, so, and later he did not even correct it. Okay. Why did the author pretend to appear like a bad-tempered man? To hide his foolish mistake, the narrator pretended that somebody had insulted him in the bank and he attempted to show to look like a man with a fearfully bad temper. What decision has the author taken after the episode at the bank? So what was the last decision he thought? After the episode at the bank, the author decided to keep his money in cash in his trousers pocket and his savings in silver dollars in a sock. Okay, so this was something wrong decision that he has taken. I hope he must have corrected his decision later on. But at present, according to the story that we have read right now, we saw that the decision that he made was that he will never go to the bank. That was his last transaction in the bank. Okay. Is the author's last decision wise? What do you all think? Do you think he has taken a wise decision? Of course, no. No. According to me, the author's last decision is not wise enough. See, there are, you know, we are human beings. Everyone makes mistakes. But we need to correct it. We need to correct our mistakes. We need to learn from our mistakes. So, the decisions that the author took, it was not correct. This behavior of the writer simply shows that he is not confident in banking, which is absolutely fine. See, everyone is not smart enough. You need to learn, okay? Maybe it's not the first time, maybe second time you can learn, maybe third time, don't know how many times, but you need to learn, okay? We can't know everything in the world, but it is absolutely wrong. If we do not improve on it, he should learn the banking system properly and continue visiting banks. He should have learned to overcome his fear of bank. Okay, so I hope everyone agrees to this. Like, there are mistakes that are committed by people, but we need to try to correct our mistakes and learn from our mistakes. Okay. Now let's move to the English workshop, page number 104. Now, find from the lesson the antonyms of the following. Antonyms, everyone knows, it is the opposites. Okay. So if you want, you can note it down or you can just take a screenshot. The antonym of afterwards is beforehand, spending, earning. Opposite of spending is earning. Withdraw, deposit. Confidently, timidly. Careful, hesitating. Cheerful, sepulchral. Okay. Question number two. Fill in the blanks. choosing the appropriate word idiom from the list. The first one, the dash solved the mysterious crime. Detective. In the examinations, I did not know the answer, so I became a hesitating J. He was dizzy and he shambled into the room. While arguing with the elders, he had made a wretched attempt to look like a man with a fearfully quick temper. The sight of a snake rattled him. As soon as I dash off my home, I greet my family, cross the threshold. Let's move on. Using the following points, frame a character sketch of the narrator. Support each character trait with instances from the lesson. Now, the first one is diffident and timid. Diffident and timid. The writer's salary had been raised to $50 a month, and the bank was the only safe place for it. But he got diffident and timid to speak to the staff in that bank. Okay, so that this shows that he was diffident and timid. Next is unusual behavior. When the narrator caught the sight of the accountant, his voice went sepulchral. He asked for the manager and added solemnly alone. That was an unsound behavior of the writer. Next one is ignorant about banking. As we have gone through the chapter, we know how ignorant the author was. The writer says, the moment he crosses the threshold of a bank, he becomes a hesitating J. And if he had to transact business there, he becomes an irresponsible idiot. So by this, we come to know that he was ignorant about banking. Nervous and careless. He gets nervous on receiving the checkbook to enter the amount to be withdrawn. So as I read the chapter, we know that he had to withdraw only $6, but because he was nervous, he wrote 56. So the writer goes careless when he enters $56 in the check instead of just six. So this part shows that he was nervous and careless. Economical. The writer's attitude gets economical when he decides to keep his money in cash in his trousers pocket and his savings in silver dollars in a sock. So we come to know that he is an economical person. He knows how to save. But of course, he is ignorant, or maybe because of his nervousness, he hates going in the bank because of the experience he had. But this thing shows that he is an economic person. Let's move on. Question number 4. Rewrite the following in indirect speech. This is the grammar part that we are covering right now. As you all know, direct speech is like when you're speaking to a person directly, and indirectly it's like, you know, describing it like a third person. So, can I see the manager? I said. Certainly, said the accountant. Now, how do we change this to indirect speech? I asked whether I could see the manager, and the accountant replied in the affirmative. Next one. Good morning, I said, and stepped into the safe. Come out, said the manager coldly. The manager ordered me coldly to go out. The word seemed to mean, let us do this painful thing while the fit is on us. Now the indirect speech of this is, the words seemed to mean that we should do that painful thing while the fit was on us. What are you drawing it all out again? He asked in surprise. Yes, the whole thing, I said. He exclaimed in surprise and asked whether I was drawing it all out again. I replied in the affirmative that I would draw the whole thing. How will you have it? He said. In 50s, I said. He asked how I would have it, and I replied that I would have it in 50s. Now, question number 5. Read the statement, write your views first and counterview later in 2 separate passages. Online net banking is better than going personally to the bank for transactions. Now, see here, in your English language paper, your written paper, you have this question for either you have option in speech writing and view counter. I've already explained this. Views is you are in favor of the topic, and counterview means you have to write the disadvantages, that is against, you're against the topic. Now, here the topic given is online net banking is better than going personally to the bank for transactions. So you have to mention your views and you have to mention your counterviews. So let's see. And this question is for 5 marks. Okay, so please pay attention to this. Now let's see the views. View means the positive things about online bank or net bank. Online banking provides plenty of benefits. Nowadays, during the COVID pandemic situation, when there was a lockdown, we all came to know like how useful online banking is. Everything was closed and we were at home safe, and we were doing whatever the transaction that we were doing it online. So it was really very useful. It is easier for customers to check their accounts, pay their bills, and move money from one account to the other. There are many perks of online banking. You get some rewards when you do the online transactions. So you have a lot of perks. With internet connection, banks are open 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Okay. First, you know, when we had to go to a bank, we had to follow the timings of the bank. Then again, the lunch hours. So, you know, you had to see at what time the bank is open and when it is closed for the lunch time, and then when are their closing hours. And looking at these hours, we had to visit the bank. But now, because it is online, they are working 24 hours a day and 365 days in a year. So the bank is never closed online. And transact, you can do the transactions anytime. Updating and maintaining a direct account is also easier. It takes minutes to change your mailing address, other additional checks, and look for current interest rates. Now, if you are transacting online, it's simple and it is quicker, very fast. You don't have to waste your time visiting the bank. Okay. And you will get the information very quickly, and the work done is in minutes. Like, you don't have to waste a lot of time. Whatever you want to change your address or any other work that you want to be done, it can be done online. Another advantage of online banking is mobility. Okay. It's quite mobile, like very easier to transact. Online banking now includes mobile capabilities, new applications are now continually being created to expand and improve their capabilities of smartphones and other mobile devices. Like nowadays, nearly many people have smartphones, so they can download the app of the bank, or they can do internet banking, and they can do their work quicker. Next amazing feature of online banking is smooth transfers. You know, first when we had to go to the bank to withdraw money, or to if we had to send money to somebody, we had to wait in long queues, and we had to, a lot of time is to be wasted. But now you can do quick, easily money transfers. Accounts can be automatically funded from a traditional bank account. It helps to transfer the money immediately and accurately. Imagine if somebody is studying out of a station or out, in another foreign country somewhere, and you need to transfer if your parents need to transfer money. Online banking is really very smooth enough and very comfortable, and you don't have to waste a lot of time. And plus, it is done very quicker. Online banking is less time consuming. Also, it is considered to be a safe and secure method, and you have permanent access to the bank. Okay? It is safe if you follow the safety norms, of course. Okay. So overall, if you go to see, we are mostly in favor of online banking and net, internet transactions. But now let's see to the counter view also. There may be, see, every, as I have already told you all in my last lecture, that a coin has two sides. So in every anything, you have the advantages and disadvantages also. So now let's see what are the disadvantages. Now the counter view. That means we have to speak against the topic, the disadvantages. One disadvantage of internet banking relates to withdrawing money. While most businesses accept debit and credit cards, people still like to have cash on them too. Now if you see your parents or even you, people have wallets, but now that wallet is full of debit cards and credit cards, no cash. Why? Because we are all into online banking, internet banking, so we don't have cash. So imagine if you have to pay cash to somebody, that person doesn't have all these facilities of online banking, then that becomes a problem for us. And of course, even we like to see our wallets full of cash. Not, of course, not heavy, like more amount, but at least some cash should be there in your wallet. Okay. So those who love keeping cash in their wallet, it is a disadvantage for them. The online banking is a disadvantage for them. Hence, you can't withdraw cash over the internet. So you still have to visit your bank's physical location or pay service fees by withdrawing money at an ATM that's not associated with your bank. Now, if you want to withdraw cash, you have a card, you have your ATM card. But if your bank's ATM is not available, you withdraw your cash from some other ATM, some other bank's ATM, you have to pay extra charges for that. So again, this is a disadvantage. Like, you want to withdraw your own money, but you have to pay extra charges for that. Okay? So that is a disadvantage. Another disadvantage of online banking is the customer service. Although online banks have implemented chatting features and other customer service numbers for those with questions and queries, it still doesn't compare to the customer service you'll receive by banking at a physical bank location. Now, see, many of us have faced this situation. When we are talking to a customer service on phone, on mobile, there are a lot of robotic messages like press 1 for this, press 2 for so and so, press 3 for, like, when you talk to a person and when you talk to a machine, there is a lot of difference. You know that that personal touch is not there. Okay, so when you visit a bank physically and when you talk to a real person, that really makes a difference. So that, we can share whatever doubts we have, we can clear our doubts. So we need actually a person, not a machine, to talk to. Next, drawback of internet banking could be that most banks make sure that their websites are secure, but no bank website is immune from cyber crime and hacking. Nowadays, this is really very common. There are a lot of hackers who hack your bank account. There are many online fraudulent phones that we receive where people try to take take all the information from us. Sometimes, unknowingly we share our passwords, which we should not do actually. But you should see, be careful. Don't share any of your personal information or any of your passwords to anyone. Okay, it should be secret, because it's really bad outside nowadays. Hackers target bank websites to swipe account information. Okay, so imagine the illiterate people or people who don't remember their passwords or who are not that techno savvy. It's really very difficult for such type of people to do online transactions. So they actually enjoy visiting a bank and talking to a person who will actually guide them.
Other pitfalls of online banking include difficulty in getting on the internet at certain times of day. Now, you know, sometimes what happens is the website is, you don't get proper internet facility. The website is not working. Maybe that is the time when you have some urgent work and that website, you know, that site is not working and your work is not done. Okay, then weekdays, evenings are the most popular. Internet connection is required for net banking. Now, if you are doing online or net banking, you should have internet facility on your phone or your laptop or your PC, your personal computer. If bank server is down or internet speed is slow, then online transaction is not possible. Okay, so remember that if you do not have proper internet facility, there will be some problems you will face while doing online transactions. One must know the basics of computers and internet in order to use internet banking. Now, if you are using online facility, that person should have basic knowledge about internet facility, about the computer knowledge, so that he can do his work properly. Further, your account can be misused if your password and PIN ID comes in the hands of an unauthorized person. If you share your password or if you share your user ID to somebody, your PIN number, then you are gone. All your money is gone from your account. So you have to be careful. Don't share your password to anyone. Okay. So these were the drawbacks, but please pay attention. It's really very risky. So please see that you don't share your password. So whenever you're doing online banking, see that you are techno-savvy enough and you have knowledge enough to do all your online work properly. And please also guide your parents or your grandparents who are not that techno-savvy, so that they don't fall prey to any these hackers who will do some work which will have a bad impact on your parents or on the financial account. Okay, so we are finished with this chapter today. I hope you all have enjoyed this topic today, this chapter. If anyone has any doubts, you can ask me.